السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين والجنة للموحدين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين لهم وعلينا معهم أجمعين. All praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our creator, our sustainer, our provider, and the choices of salutations in abundance upon his most beloved Habib, our master, Sayyidina Mawlana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, upon his noble and illustrious of companions, the Sahaba Hikiram, and upon his noble and purified household, Ahlul Bayt Ajma'in. Welcome, dear viewers, to the latest episode of Al-Akhlaq. Inshallah, today we will be discussing the subject of humility and humbleness. As Muslims, before we start, we must come to realize that we are insignificant beings in respect to our Creator. We are slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And therefore, as slaves, we have to be humble in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, the topic of tawadu', humbleness, is a very broad and great aspect of our deen, of our religion. It should cover every aspect on how we interact with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how we interact with the noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, and how we interact with humanity. Tawadu, humbleness, basically means to submit, to become submissive in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Quran states, Inna akramakum inda Allahi atqaakum, the best amongst you and the noblest amongst you in the sight of Allah is he who is the most conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in various verses commands us that we should be humble, walk on this earth with humility, not with pride and arrogance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, وَلَا تُصَعِرْ غَدَّقَ لِلنَّاسِ وَلَا تَمْشِ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحَا إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ كُلَّ مُخْتَالٍ فَخُورٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, do not walk with haughtiness and pride, and do not interact with arrogance with people, and do not walk with insolence through the earth, and walk with humility, and for indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not love the arrogant boaster. As human beings, we have to be humble in front of Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not look at our status. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not look at our wealth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not look at our beauty. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not look at our intelligence or knowledge. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks at the state of our heart. As Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam is reported to have said, Inna Allah ta'ala la yanzuru ila suwarikum wa la ila ajsamikum walakin yanzuru ila kulubikum. For indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not look at our outer beauty. He does not look at our shape. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not look at our body and our beauty. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks at the condition of our heart, whether it's humble in front of him subhanahu wa ta'ala. For we are the slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as the saying goes, innamal kibriyahu lillahi rabbil alameen, that pride is the sole prerogative of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is our creator. We as insignificant servants and slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should walk with humility, humble ourselves in front of the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, man tawada'a lillah rafa'ahu Allahu bihi. Aw kama qala Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, whoever humbles themselves in the presence of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise him in the presence of humanity. Now, you come to understand this attribute of humbleness is very great. It was the very lack of it that caused Shaitan, Iblis one, to be thrown out of the glorious paradise and to be thrown and become the cursed one, that even until the day of Qiyamah he will never be forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is condemned to an eternal life in the fire of Jahannam simply because he lacked this humility. He was an abid, a worshipper par excellence. He was amongst the greatest of worshippers to such an extent that Iblis used to perform the ibadah in the presence of the great malaika themselves. But because when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about it in the Holy Quran, Quran, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي خَالِقٌ بَشَرًا مِنْ طِينٍ فَإِذَا سَوَّيْتُهُ وَنَفَخْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي فَقَعُوا لَهُ سَاجِدِينَ فَسَجَدَ الْمَلَائِكَةُ كُلُّهُمْ أَجْمَعُونَ إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ اسْتَكْبَرَ وَكَانَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He told His angels that indeed I am going to create a creation, a human being from clay, فَإِذَا سَوَّيْتُهُ وَنَفَخْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي, and I am going to blow into him and breathe into him a spirit which I will create into him, فَقَعُوا لَهُ سَاجِدِينَ, so you must prostrate and make sajda and humble yourselves in front of that creation of mine. فَسَجَدَ الْمَلَائِكَ كُلُّهُمْ أَجْمَعُونَ, every single angel obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obeyed the command of the Creator, and they made sajda in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Adam alayhi salatu wa salam, except Iblis from among the jinn. He alone disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Istakbara, he was pride and haughty and arrogant. وَكَانَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ, and he became one of the disbelievers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala questions him. And Allah ta'ala says, قَالَ يَا إِبْلِيسِ مَا مَنَأَكَ أَن تَشْهُدَ لِمَا خَلَقْتُ بِيَدَيْ أَأَسْتَكْبَرْتَ أَمْ كُنْتَ مِنَ الْعَالِينَ. Then Allah ta'ala says, O Iblis, O cursed one, what stopped you from making sajda to what I have created with my own hands? I commanded you to bow and submit to the creation of Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. It was my command. Are you proud, arrogant? Are you haughty? Or you think to yourself to be of higher obedience that you do not wish to obey my command? And then Iblis replied, قَالَ أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِّنْ خَلَقْتَنِي مِنْ نَارٍ وَخَلَقْتَهُ مِنْ تِينٍ. To which Iblis replied, O Allah, I am better than him. You created me from fire and you created him from clay, and fire is greater and more powerful than clay. Hence Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala thereafter banished him and cursed him. قَالَ فَخْرُجْ مِنْهَا, get away from here, expel yourself, you are removed from my close proximity, and indeed you are the cursed one from now on. This is simply because he had arrogance, pride, that he was better than Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. And this is what happens, that in fact it is an irony in our lives as well, because the more we become humble in our worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the irony is that we think ourselves to be better than another person, a better worshipper, a better lover of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a better scholar of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a better obedient servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we look down on one another, we scoff at one another, we speak ill of one another, we lift our heads high with pride and arrogance, and we are not conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the reason that Iblis was thrown out of the paradise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the reason that the Muslims are losing their way, because no matter how much they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this quality of pride and kibr and takabbur does not release itself from the heart, and humbleness does not come into our hearts. We are not humble enough, we are not submissive enough to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the very definition of a Muslim is he who is submissive to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the very object Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, qibr, is to reject the truth and to look down upon people. And this is what we do because perhaps of our social standing, perhaps because of our wealth and our affluent state, because of our knowledge, because of our beauty, because of our wisdom or our popularity, we look down on the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We look down on people, we insult them, we hurt them, we torment them. We walk on this earth as we are the greatest creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And yet Allah ta'ala says, وَلَا تَمْشِ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحًا, and do not walk with insolence through the earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, lower your voice, speak humbly to people, do not raise your voice, do not hurt another person's feelings. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ كُلَّ مُخْتَارٍ فَخُورٍ, for indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not love the arrogant boaster. And this is the quality that we need to inculcate. We need to put in our hearts that when we step out out of our doors, out of our homes, out of our classes, out of our cars, that we must not look at another human being and say he's lower than us. We see people begging, and we all are guilty of this in one way or another. We see people on the streets, the traffic lights. We see people coming and stretching out their hands. We see people that are dressed properly or beautifully. We see people that we deem to understand they are of lesser intellect, and we look down upon them, we mock them, we are sarcastic towards them, we are hurtful towards them. And this is not the quality of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's attribute, and not the quality in the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam treated people with humility, treated people with respect, treated people with love. And despite being the beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, every single day of his life was life of simplicity, a life of respect for another human being, irrespective of whether the human being was a Muslim or not. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam treated humanity with respect. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam treated another human being with love. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, if you look at his life history, he lived a life of humbleness, slept on a straw mat. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, despite being the master of both the worlds, and despite being promised by Allah to give him the entire mountain's worth of gold, he chose to live a life of humility, because he knew, as the dua the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam used to make, "Oh Allah, raise me and bring me up with the humble. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused me to die among the humble, and gather me up on the day of Qiyamah with those that are humble on the day of resurrection." This was the dua that Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam make. And inshallah, before we go for the ad break, we will discuss after the ad break inshallah the seerah of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, his humbleness towards his family, his humbleness towards the less fortunate, his humbleness towards the less pious, his humbleness towards the poor, his humbleness towards humanity, and his humbleness towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And inshallah, we will continue after the ad break inshallah. Ma'as-salam.